Queen Elizabeth II's 95th birthday Wednesday is expected to be a more somber affair than her milestone 90th, taking place under continuing restrictions of the coronavirus pandemic and just days after the funeral of her husband of 73 years, Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. She reaches this significant age marker in good health, but no doubt still grieving the loss of the Iron Duke, as he was affectionately known, as the official period of mourning draws to an end. The Queen shared this sentiment in a message Wednesday and gave thanks for condolences following her husband's death. "I have, on the occasion of my 95th birthday today, received many messages of good wishes, which I very much appreciate," the statement read. "While as a family we are in a period of great sadness, it has been a comfort to us all to see and to hear the tributes paid to my husband, from those within the United Kingdom, the Commonwealth and around the world." She added, "My family and I would like to thank you for all the support and kindness shown to us in recent days. We have been deeply touched, and continue to be reminded that Philip had such an extraordinary impact on countless people throughout his life." The Duke died early on April 9th in his private apartment at Windsor Castle, the Queen at his side, a few weeks after a lengthy hospitalization. He was 99, just short of his 100th birthday in June. He had been her closest advisor and supporter, the longest-serving royal consort in British history, and the man credited with helping to make her long reign a success. At Windsor Castle, the routine business of the crown went on. Just 4 days after her husband's death, the Queen carried out an already scheduled engagement, presiding over a retirement ceremony on April 13th for her most senior royal household official, according to the court circular, the official record of royal engagements. The Lord Chamberlain, the Earl Peel, who oversaw the arrangements for the funeral of Prince Philip, met with the Queen, delivered up the insignia of his office and took his leave after the Queen invested him with the Royal Victorian Chain. The next day, the Queen held another audience to welcome the new Lord Chamberlain, Lord Andrew Parker, and pass on the insignia of office, according to the court circular. From this, there seems little doubt the Queen will keep calm and carry on, because that's what she promised to do when she was 21. She will continue to serve as the United Kingdom's head of state, albeit while curtailing some of her in-person appearances to protect against COVID-19. Even if Prince Philip were still alive, the Queen's real birthday would have been a private celebration. Now COVID requires she remain cloistered in Windsor Castle and she is still in mourning, so a big family party is not on. For past significant birthdays, the palace released an official portrait along with tributes on royal social media.